9 out of these. And negative 4 out of here. And this is where a lot of people are making mistakes. You're factoring a negative 4 out of these two terms. So that's going to be x squared plus 6x. Right? I mean, you should always think about these things backward. If I distributed that minus 4 through here, I'm going to get negative 4x squared minus 24x, right? A lot of people are using a plus, a minus sign. But if you distribute a negative 4 times a negative 6, that would give you a positive 24. Be careful with that. Okay, so now we complete the square. So on this one, I add a 1. And subtract. Right, this half of 2 is 1. 1 squared is 1. And on this one, what do I add?
Adding a 9.
9. Half of 6 is 3, and 3 squared is 9. So I add a 9. So we get that.
So it's going to go on the other side.
Okay. Then we're going to factor those three and those three. These three are going to factor y minus 1 squared. And I still have that minus 1. These three are going to factor as x plus 3 squared. And I still have that minus 9. Are you guys starting to get more comfortable with this business of completing the square? Okay, because it's going to pop up. Alright, so now I'm going to distribute that 9
here. Because of the way we started the equation, is that going to be that? The one we were talking about, which one's going to be up or down? So since the y started out positive,
negative 4,
we started to put the y, this equation.
Everybody knows that you're really distributing a negative 4 through here, right? Not a positive 4. That negative sign is glued to that 4. You're distributing a negative 4.
Does that make sense?
I think you just missed it. That's all I was
like. Negative 4 times negative 9 is positive 36.
So whenever the y is first, it's up and down. Okay.
Then we're just going to move the 9 and the 36. Divide everything by 36, because we got to get a 1 here. And so the 9 over 36, that's 4. We can reduce that. Y minus 1 squared over 4. And the same here, we can reduce to 4 over 36. X plus 3 squared over 9. So this is standard form. Everybody okay with that? You want to find the focus? Do you want me to do it?
We're
Alright, so the center of this thing.
It's gonna be -3 and 1. -3 and 1.
-3, 1. X is -3, Y is 1. Center. This hyperbola opens which way?
Up and down.
Up and down, because the y is
x is negative.
The positive. Right. So if we want to go through the trouble of building that rectangle, in the y direction we go up 2 and down 2. In the x direction we go over 3. Then we build this box. These are going to be the asymptotes. And to draw to graph it, we start here, and it's going to follow those asymptotes there, and there. So that's a graph of the hyperbola. The foci are going to be somewhere in there. Get the c squared by adding 4 plus 9. Which is 13. So c is the square of 13. So the center right there is -3, 1. So to get to the upper focus, we add at square root of 13, 1. Right, so this one's going to be yeah, you can do plus or minus the square root of 13 if you want. And to get that focus, you're going to subtract the square root of 13 from the 1. Or you can do it plus or minus. So -3, then 1 plus or minus the square root of 13. Those are the two. Explain how you can tell when you have